Let's do it.
Action.
Tell me about your directing process in film.
When I direct, to direct a film, you must have a focused concentration. When I'm directing, you cannot direct me into distraction. Cannot. I won't direct that.
How many times have you worked with this crew?
I've only worked with one crew member on this crew before, and that would be the cinematic photographer, Old McGee. Genius.
I was told that he is actually blind.
What are you saying, that he can't see?
Oh, I can see. I just can't use 82.5% of my vision.
Don't you need all of your vision for a job like cinema?
Look, if you have half your vision, you can work in this town.
But you don't have half, right?
No.
How important is sound to your production?
Well, sound would have to be probably one of the most crucial parts of the production.
It is?
According to St. Clair Marshall.
Man, I don't know what I'm doing, man. I found this stuff in the locker at my last job.
And what job was that?
Something I found on Craigslist, I don't know.
But what do you know?
Nothing, according to you.
Do you write the material as well?
No. No.
We're writers. We write.
How long have the two of you been collaborating?
2, 3, 4 days.
Where did you guys study? USC? NYU? Yale School of Drama? Or did you have any formal study?
You know what? Let's just skip past all the technical stuff, because that's really not the most important part of production. The acting. It's the acting.
I can do impressions of Sly Stallone, Arnold, Van Damme, but it's time for Chap Harris. Me. When St. Clair came to me with this project, I saw this as my break to show off my abilities in an action film. But when he told me that he wanted to use a stunt double, I became disturbed.
Do you think that you can do anything else for me?
I don't want to hear it, okay?
I don't know if I like this.
Look, Chap, we got you a stunt double. He looks exactly like you. Come on out. He looks exactly like you. Chap Harris is...
Whoa, don't touch me, man. This is my cheek.
Sorry about that.
You got the scripts.
I have a game plan, and I can't get out of it.
I know St. Clair, and he's really pissing me off because he promised me I would star in this. Better yet, he told me I wouldn't even have to audition. I show up for the meeting, and there's this little Pop-Tart looking at me. At me! A few weeks later, I get a phone call that some bitch named Serene Winston will star in this. I tried talking to the writers to see if there was anything they could do. Yeah, a lot of good that did. So now I, of all people, have become second to some upstart named Serene.
Well, at least her name can be found in the English language.
I can't believe I'm in a film. I mean, I can believe it because I'm that good, but you gotta be humble, right? At the Juilliard School, we're taught that the actor's body needs to be well-versed in a range of motion.
You attended Juilliard?
No, I didn't.
Action. No.
First of all, he didn't even go to film school. I mean, what? You go to a weekend workshop and now all of a sudden you think you're Cecil damn DeMille? No. Walking in here with those fake-ass glasses on talking about, they're my retinal shields. They don't make you look interesting, your breath is funky, and stop picking your wedgies and sniffing them in front of people. We can see you.
So tomorrow is your first day of shooting. Nervous?
You know what? No. I just like to quote William Howard Shakespeare's play, Hamlet. The readiness is all.
Shakespeare didn't have a middle name.
But he did write that though, right?
We're ready to film, crew. Old McGee.
It's about damn time. Here's your damn film, bigger than the whole damn camera. So what?
Where's the real film?